Hi, this is Dr. Shawn Talbott, MonaVie's Chief Science Officer, and welcome to another edition of From the Lab. Today, we wanted to have a little bit of fun, and we're going to talk about a recurring myth that I get asked questions about all the time. And this is the myth of, can your body be too acidic, and should you try to alkalize your body to fight that acidity? They'll also say that acid, your body being in an acidic environment, will lead to all sorts of problems, arthritis and memory problems, and you fill in the blank here. And one of the reasons I have a problem with that is that when you look throughout the body actually does an exquisite job of maintaining its own pH, its own level of when should you be acidic, when should you be alkaline. And a good example of that is just think about your digestive tract. Think about where your food starts to be digested. It's in your mouth. The saliva in your mouth is actually a little bit alkaline. It's a little bit to the side of less acidic than to the side of acidic. And that's interesting. We start off there, we're a little bit alkaline. But then when we go down into the stomach, we get to a place where we are highly acidic, very, very acidic. One of the most acidic places on the entire planet is your stomach. And you need to do that so that you can digest your food, especially proteins, appropriately so that they can be absorbed throughout the rest of the digestive tract, primarily your small intestine. But then when we do pass into the small intestine, across the entire intestine, you're going from a state of very low acidity to less acidity, and you actually even flip over into being alkaline in certain portions. And then you can look at your blood, and your blood is pretty much neutral. It's about even between alkaline and acidic. And so, I'll ask people, what does your diet look like? The best way to maintain that normal balance of some acid and some alkaline in your body is to do what you've probably heard already. Eat a wide variety of brightly colored fruits and vegetables, get enough fiber in your diet, get enough calcium and magnesium in your diet, reduce your intake as much as possible of highly refined sugars, especially sodas, reduce your intake of red meat so it's no more than a couple of times a week, increase your intake of omega-3 fatty acids and downplay your intake of omega-6s. You know, if you're doing all of those things, you're already modulating your body's own acid-base balance. You know, as a scientist, I'm always on the lookout for scientific evidence to support or refute some sort of a theory like this. And when you look out there in the scientific literature, the peer-reviewed scientific literature, there really isn't a lot of scientific substantiation for that idea about being acid as bad, alkaline as good. It's not quite that simple. But you can get too acidic. There was a series of studies conducted at some universities in Boston, one of which was Tufts University, where they fed people artificially high acid loads. They gave people lots of soda, refined sugar, lots of red meat, and then low intakes of foods that would be considered anti-acid, things like dairy with calcium and magnesium and yogurts and things like that. So you can really get your body to be acidic if you're focusing yourself on that, if you're drinking a lot of soda, if you're eating a lot of red meat, if you're not taking in some of those things that I had before or that I mentioned before. That is sometimes the standard American diet, or what we call SAD. It's a sad diet because it can cause problems in the body. What happens though is that your body doesn't stay acidic. Your body wants to get you back into pH balance, and so what happens is your body starts to get calcium out of the bones. And so what these studies showed from Tufts University is that if you are eating that high acid load kind of a diet, lots of red meat, lots of soda, lots of refined sugars, your body your bones are bleeding out calcium into your bloodstream to buffer that acid. And so your body doesn't stay acid for very long. In fact, it only stays that way for a few minutes. So, people will sometimes, after I explain that to them, they'll say, well, what should I do? And I'll go back to what I mentioned just a few minutes ago. I'll say, the way to do that is to eat a balanced diet. And then they'll get this look on their face. And it's always the same look. And it's the look of, well, I can't do all of that. I can't eat 10 servings of brightly colored fruits and vegetables every day. I can't avoid the fast food occasionally. I can't eat the perfect diet. And I admit to them, I say, hey, I'm right there with you. I can't eat the perfect diet, and I'm a professional nutritionist. And so what can you do? You can do that, eat as well as possible, as much as possible. And then when you can't, you can come to a company like MonaVie that has products like our antioxidant juices that can give you healthy fatty acids, that can give you a wide array of antioxidants that you're not getting in those fruits and vegetables. If you're not getting those healthy carbs and those healthy proteins and those high amounts of fibers in your other parts of your diet, we can give you a meal replacement shake like the Reveal shakes. If you are looking for some sort of a pick-me-up instead of reaching for one of those highly refined sodas, which we know are so bad for health, you can reach for a healthy form of an energy drink and a sugar such as isomaltulose that's absorbed much slower and doesn't have that sort of acidifying effect in the body. And so what that acid change really is it's a signal that your body is becoming overoxidized. We have a solution for that. It's a signal that your body is not handling blood sugar appropriately. We have a solution for that. It's a signal that your body might be under stress and is causing that stress response. We have products that address that issue as well. So I like to kind of flip the story of acid base and the idea that acid is associated with disease and alkaline is associated with health. It's really not that simple. And I like to flip it a little bit and say, if you got your antioxidants and you got your healthy sugars and you're able to modulate your stress response and you're able to do all of that at the same time, we wouldn't even be having this conversation. Your body would be in perfect balance. Your body would balance blood sugar, balance your free radicals and antioxidants, balance your stress hormones, balance your energy levels. You would feel great. Your flexibility would be good. Your motivation would be there. That's what we all want. We all want to feel great physically and mentally and emotionally, and that's what these MonaVie products can do. So the next time you hear this, it's a recurrent kind of myth that comes up. You'll read magazine articles about it. You'll see blogs about it on the internet. But now you know a little bit more. You know that that is really something that is overly simplified, and underlying that is really this idea that we're doing at MonaVie, which is balance the body in all of these important ways that are legitimately backed by strong science. And that's what we try to do here at From the Lab, is explain to you what the science says and how we use that science and build that into the products that you can plug into your life so that you can feel better and look better and perform better. That's what it's all about. So thanks for joining me on this edition of From the Lab. This is Dr. Shawn Talbott. See you next time. Hey, this is Dr. Shawn Talbott. Don't forget to send in your questions so that we can answer them on future editions of From the Lab. Just send your emails to the address that you see at the bottom of the screen. Thanks.